Relatives of Russian families that fled to ISIL say they've recognized some of the children filmed by an RT crew in an orphanage in Baghdad. The Russian-speaking children were placed there after they were rescued during the battle to liberate the city of Mosul from Islamic State.
Мама тоже была. Потом Халан опять скинул, и огонь на нас попало. Огонь я услышала, и мы сразу афатами стекло вот сюда зашла тапочку. Фатим. Она плакала. У нас нет. Сестра лежит возле речки. Они там двое. Еще Юсуф. Там еще ляльки, но он по камени, на камени лежал и умер. И его мама тоже умер.
Папа лежал на камне, и он умер. Глаза закрыл.
Если мой папа живой будет, я скажу, что Фатима меня забрала.
Я скажу маме, чтобы меня забрали.
It's believed they were taken to Iraq by their parents, who joined Islamic State and who are now presumed dead. Russia, Iraq and Jordan are working to track down other family members. RT joined the search operation. The video we just showed you was posted on our social media pages and was shared by the head of Russia's Chechen Republic, Ramzan Kadyrov. It was after this that some of the relatives contacted us. Ilya Petrenko joins me now in the studio with more on the story. Hi there, Ilya. First off, give us some background into the story.
Emily, hello. Well, first of all, of course, we can remember what happened with the liberation of Mosul. First, there was joy and praise about the victory. We saw a delighted Iraqi prime minister arriving in Mosul as he declared that victory. But what did he see there? He saw almost total destruction, and a humanitarian catastrophe can mean many things. But just take a moment to think of the many abandoned children that were found among that destruction. Now, we sent one of our cameras to one of the shelters in Baghdad where the children that were found in Mosul were treated. And the journalist that was filming the story actually found out that some of these children were speaking Russian. And the only things that these kids could remember were hunger, war, and death. And some of them could even describe how they saw their parents being killed. And it turned out that dozens of Russian-speaking children can be found all around Iraq in different shelters. They were presumably born and raised in Russia before their parents took them to Iraq or Syria to join Islamic State. Now, then, of course, these are the kind of things that we're still working on now.
Well, how has the search been so far for the relatives of these children? Has it been successful?
Well, as I've been saying, we really tried to put together some kind of video, and we put it all over our social network accounts, sorry. The search was, of course, joined by other people, most notably, as you've mentioned, the head of the Chechen Republic, Ramzan Kadyrov. And at the very end of that video, you can find an email that we put together specially for this project. And, of course, there was barely any hope that we get some answers, but I can tell you that the first emails with the actual photos have begun coming in. I just want to show you some of them. So here is the photo of Ali. Hopefully you can see it on the left side of the screen, and what you can see, sorry, on the right side, and what you can see on the left is the screenshot from our video. As you can see, the resemblance is absolutely evident. Now, the person who contacted us was Ali's aunt, and what she said was that apparently the father of Ali is now dead, but at least his mother stayed in touch with the family. Last time that happened was about a year ago, and we can also show you a different photo where apparently we can see Ali with his mother, and in the top right corner there's the flag of Islamic State, which is of course a horrendous story. What we know about this boy is that his family back in Russia, they really begged at least Ali's mother, to try and send him back to Russia, but that never happened.
Right, so what about other children besides from Ali?
So, of course, again, as I was saying, it is very difficult to find the parents of these children, but we got other emails, we got more photos, and here's Sultan Murad. His story is very similar to that of Ali's. Again, on the right side, we can see the actual photo of Murad from the archives. Then on the left, a boy who really looks like Sultan Murad, we heard from his aunt as well. And she said that what we know for sure is that his father's dead. His mother last time reached out to the family about 10 months ago, which makes the story very similar to that of Ali's. But there are also sisters, Hadija and Fatima. We don't know the fate of their parents at all. What we heard from their distant relatives that got in touch with RT was that apparently the parents of the sisters moved to Turkey, and this was their last stop before they joined Islamic State, before they joined the jihadists. So the fate of the relatives is completely unknown, but what we do know is that at least these four children, they got a chance to come back to their relatives pending a DNA test. So that is, of course, our number one hope right now, that this can lead to some kind of results. And of course, we're also waiting for more emails and photos.
Well, thank you so much for giving us that update on this very, very emotional story. Thank you. That was Ilya Petrenko.
Over our social network account, the search was, of course, joined by other people, most notably, as you've mentioned, the head of the Chechen Republic, Ramzan Kadyrov. And at the very end of that video, you can find an email that we put together specially for this project. And of course, there was barely any hope that we get some answers, but I can tell you that the first emails with the actual photos have begun coming in. I just want to show you some of them. So here is the photo of Ali. Hopefully you can see it on the left side of the screen, and what you can see, sorry, on the right side, and what you can see on the left is the screenshot from our video. As you can see, the resemblance is absolutely evident. Now, the person who contacted us was Ali's aunt, and what she said was that apparently the father of Ali is now dead, but at least his mother stayed in touch with the family. Last time that happened was about a year.
Если мой папа живой будет, я скажу, что Фатима меня забрала.
Я скажу маме, чтобы меня забрали.
It's believed they were taken to Iraq by their parents, who joined Islamic State and who are now presumed dead. Russia, Iraq, and Jordan are working to track down other family members. RT joined the search operation. The video we just showed you was posted on our social media pages and was shared by the head of Russia's Chechen Republic, Ramzan Kadyrov. It was after this that some of the relatives contacted us. Ilya Petrenko joins me now in the studio with more on the story. Hi there, Ilya. First off, give us some background into the story.
Emily, hello. Well, first of all, of course, we can remember what happened with the liberation of Mosul. First, there was joy and praise about the victory. We saw a delighted Iraqi prime minister arriving in Mosul as he declared that victory. But what did he see there? He saw almost total destruction. And a humanitarian catastrophe can mean many things. But just take a moment to think of the many abandoned children that were found among that destruction. Now, we sent one of our cameras to one of the shelters in Baghdad where the children that were found in Mosul were treated. And the journalist that was filming the story actually found out that some of these children were speaking Russian. And the only things that these kids could remember were hunger, war, and death. And some of them could even describe how they saw their parents being killed. And it turned out that dozens of Russian-speaking children can be found all around Iraq in different shelters. They were presumably born and raised in Russia before their parents took them to Iraq or Syria to join Islamic State. Now, then, of course, these are the kind of things that we're still working on now.
Well, how has the search been so far for the relatives of these children? Has it been successful?
Well, as I've been saying, we really tried to put together some kind of video, and we put it all over.
Relatives of Russian families that fled to ISIL say they've recognized some of the children filmed by an RT crew in an orphanage in Baghdad. The Russian-speaking children were placed there after they were rescued during the battle to liberate the city of Mosul from Islamic State.
И мама тоже была. Потом Халан опять скинул, и огонь на нас попало. Огонь я услышала, и мы сразу Фатиме стекло вот сюда зашла тапочку. Фатиме плакала. У нас сестра лежит возле речки. Они там двое. Еще Юсуф. Там еще ляльки, но он по камени, на камени лежал и умер. И его мама тоже умер.
Папа лежал на камне, и он умер.
Year ago, and we can also show you a different photo where apparently we can see Ali with his mother. And in the top right corner, there's the flag of Islamic State, which is, of course, a horrendous story. What we know about this boy is that his family back in Russia, they really begged, at least, Ali's mother to try and send him back to Russia, but that never happened.
Right, so what about other children besides from Ali?
So, of course, again, as I was saying, it is very difficult to find the parents of these children. But we got other emails, we got more photos. And here's Sultan Murad. His story is very similar to that of Ali's. Again, on the right side, we can see the actual photo of Murad from the archives. Then on the left, a boy who really looks like Sultan Murad. We heard from his aunt as well. And she said that what we know for sure is that his father's dead. His mother last time reached out to the family about 10 months ago, which makes the story very similar to that of